Everything in this video can be found on the public domain, and the full disclaimers down below.
Hey, welcome back to the Danger Zone. It's Ashley. I wish you lots of love and many blessings. Very special thank you to Peter and Jay, Connie and Deborah. This video is sponsored by Tesla Biohealing. Experience the new wave of medicine and technology. For patients with terminal cancer, Alzheimer's, dementia, stroke paralysis, or COPD, they offer an at-home program. They bring proven scientific medical research and modern technology together to enrich, enhance, and extend the lives of their patients. And this spring, they offer major discounts at the Tesla Biohealing Center. Consultations in person or by phone are always free. They have excellent policies in place, as well as top-notch reviews. What do you have to lose, really? I totally stand behind them, 100%. And if you're not interested in their services, but fascinated like I am with this technology, check down below in the description for their information. It is mind-blowing. He's trapped. He's miserable. And he didn't know any of this until Megan told him. When Oprah asked him in that interview, "How do you know you're trapped?" he pointed at Megan and said, "She told me." According to an article I was reading, they say she blatantly used the tragic life and death of Diana to convince him history was repeating itself and she was being targeted by the royals, hell-bent on destroying her too. He's been saying this from the jump. I'm so thrilled folks are waking up. She talked him into believing escaping Britain was the only way to save her life and his own. And that little situation started happening as soon as she found out she wasn't going to get her own way in the royal family. And she was making all sorts of crazy claims, saying her life in the royal family was so hellacious and miserable. Finally confessing to Harry that, "Hey look, even though we're pregnant, quote unquote, with our first child, I still don't feel like being here anymore." I'm shocked and surprised she didn't try to throw herself down a flight of stairs like Diana did when she was pregnant. She absolutely went in doing her homework on Princess Diana and everything else royals. How else could you even remember? I mean, she's not missed a beat in mimicking everything Diana's done or said or dressed in. I am not kidding y'all when I tell you I've watched a ton of crime TV in my days. I've never seen a criminal this absolutely hung up in all of my life. Now, what's been told to me is Harry's finding his footing there in California now that he's a working man. Both of these positions, if you want to call it that, are work from home. But that does not mean he's been sticking around lately. He's like a tick, y'all, on a dog's behind. She's tried her best to get rid of him. She wants him to get out and have a little fun, and boy, has he. She put him off on Nick Collins. This was her former agent. Seems they've had a huge blow up. He's no longer working for Megan. Not anymore. Was his influence on Harry what caused this blow up? Who knows? In time, it'll come out. Evidently, somebody she's introduced him to has introduced him to these adult supper clubs he's so fond of these days. Harry has quite a party boy past. Somebody has introduced him to these supper clubs that are all over California. As a result of him going out having a good time with his new friends, she's not liking at all what she's seeing. He's not that easily controllable these days. I've been told this has caused nothing but problems between the both of them. And she's been spending a lot more time away from that mansion. She's never in the same place. That's what's being said. She, Marcus, and somebody that's described as Omid Scobie have been all over the northern part of California, never in the same place. It's so bad that her business managers have to track her down just to hand her important paperwork. Meanwhile, all we're hearing about lately is Harry. And I guess it stands to reason. He's on his own. He's doing his own thing. He's enjoying his supper clubs, his new friends, and she's not thrilled. She created that codependent monster, and then she created the problem. Pawning him off on everybody else, on her old friends, her business associates, getting him off of her. I honestly feel like she never dreamed this would backfire, but it has. So it seems. Remember when they first got there, he was hanging out with Adele, and she wasn't going to have that for too long. She put an end to it really fast. She even at one point tried contacting George for him to hang out with. George and Ma have their own problems. They don't need theirs too. And his daddy away from daddy, David Foster and his wife Catherine, have a real baby to tend to. They don't have time to babysit Harry also. She really can't get mad at nobody but herself. She cooked her own goose. One thing about these supper clubs is they are quite discreet. Everything I keep finding out about them, anything goes. And it seems to be a real good time if you're into that. And we know Harry is. Hey, according to his good buddy Ronnie Vannucci from the Killers band, that guy would brag about what a good kisser Harry was. Yeah, according to him, Harry's always been into this. I've always heard stories about the Soho House and Meghan and Marcus's relationship with Harry. So who can she be mad at but herself? I believe we'll hear about this more and more often. Harry's feeling himself, y'all. He's found a sense of freedom, especially now that she's cut him off the leash. Harvey Weinstein admitted he had a sweet tooth for Harry back in 2010. Friend Connie pointed out recently. It just seems like he's sort of the pinnacle of everything that's going down right now, of their circle of friends. And do you guys remember when Harvey was bragging to everybody right before that wedding took place that he had spent some quote-unquote time with the future royal bride? So it seems a little peculiar that Meghan was depending an awful lot on Harvey right after that wedding took place for all sorts of advice. I can't say this is fact or fiction. I'm just telling you what the rumor is. When Harry had it out with his dad over needing more money, an increase in his allowance, and Charles said no way. It was Harvey that extended his pocketbook to Harry and Meghan, giving them a little extra help when they needed it most. Here recently. Must be nice to have friends in high places, even if they are in prison. This is getting nastier and nastier by the day, so it seems. I'm wondering exactly when Harry will get his mind back together. And I'm not saying it'll ever be the same again between Harry and his family, and it shouldn't. It really shouldn't be. But maybe he'll find somewhere in his heart to learn how to apologize. But for the time being, they are both demanding that Catherine and William give them a public apology for everything they've put Meghan through. And according to a royal spokesperson, the answer to that is absolutely not. In all actuality, Meghan owes them a huge thank you. 3 years ago, when the initial complaints to the royal family by the staff that were being bullied and mistreated so terribly by Meghan first came out, Catherine and William worked really hard on keeping this under wraps. They didn't want anything out there that could hurt Meghan or Harry. So all of this time, for the last 3 years, they've done Meghan and Harry a massive favor. No good deed goes unpunished. I've always had to learn this the hard way. I hope you're having a really good day today. I'll see you soon and we'll talk fast. Y'all please stay safe and be blessed.